loose. They turn on the juice. You know I love to see my electric company turn on the juice. Turn them loose. Turn on the juice.
Let's see what we're made of.
Stay in the huddle.
Let's go right here, front four. Who's going to make the first tackle? That's what I want to know. Who's going to make it?
All of us.
Let's go. We got to stop them right here. Nothing. Watch your long bomb, babe. Let's go now. Let's do it. Take it two-hole mad dog. Double left. 41 double left.
Watch the reverse and bootleg.
Okay. Wait! Double wing! Special! Special!
384!
Forget it, Gomer. Forget it, Gomer.
Out!
Come out!
Defense puts a knot in the pit of the stomach.
And the fans love it. The Buffalo Wrecking Crew was big and devastating. At right end, Tom Day was a study in mobile destruction. Tom Sestak at right tackle had one of his best years. At left tackle, number 78 Jim Dunaway displayed the aggressiveness that won him a spot on the AFL Eastern All-Star team. Number 72 Ron McDowell was at left end. As foreman of the wrecking crew, he was its most consistent player. Left linebacker Paul Guidry, in his first season as a starter, performed with alert efficiency. Right linebacker Mike Stratton, number 58, was a student of the hit-and-run style. Number 57, Marty Schottenheimer, did it all when he filled in at middle linebacker. Cornerback Butch Bird led the team with 6 interceptions and was toughest with his back to the wall. Number 26, George Sames, played right safety. Like Bird and Stratton, he was an all-star. The Bills had depth at left safety, where number 27, Tom Yannick, was a man of many talents. When Yannick was injured, number 48, John Pitts, filled in with excellent ability.